In John chapter 7, Jesus was speaking. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus spoke. And I think it's high time we began to take Jesus' speeches very seriously. If he said it, I don't know what makes us think that it won't come to pass. Or maybe we don't think so. Maybe it's just an attitude. But I think if you are not expecting it to come to pass, then it's as bad as not believing it. Everything he said has come to pass and has still coming to pass. And so I pray a prayer for me every day. I say, let me take seriously everything he has said. Open my eyes to see them. In John chapter 7, he was talking in verse 37 and 38 and 7. On the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Anyone. So all or every one person is qualified, regardless of your background, regardless of what you've been through, regardless of what I've been through you. The only requirement is that you believe him. Come, say you will drink. And that kind of water that when you drink, you don't get thirsty again. It becomes a well inside of you. Glory be to God in the highest. I just want to talk about Christianity today. Oh, who is a Christian? You know, we started looking at it for a while, but last Sunday, we're looking at the consciousness of Christianity. It says, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me. So there's no controversy. There's no argument about it. The object of belief is clear. It's a person. It's not a doctrine. It's not a principle. It's a person. His name is Jesus. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart, out of his belly, shall what? Flow. Flow what? River. Hallelujah. So, if I'm a Christian, if indeed I'm a Christian, this river must flow. No, Pastor, things have changed. These are modern times. No, is Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever? This has not changed. If it's not flowing, you are yet to get there. And it should flow from your belly, from your heart. That means that it will overrun your mind and overtake your flesh. Yeah. And it will reach out to people. So out of my belly, it's not a new truth, it's been there before I was born again. But it's beginning to get clear to me that the same life that flowed out of Jesus should flow out of me. In the same manner that he flowed out of Jesus. Yeah? The same way he said it, I didn't say it. And he will never lie. But this, he spoke concerning the Spirit. Hallelujah. So it makes it easier for us. This he spoke concerning the Spirit, whom those believing in him would receive. Anybody? Is there a believer in the house? Then something changes for you from today. In the name of Jesus. What I'm saying is that the real you will begin to manifest. In the name of Jesus. Glory be to God in the highest. Your day of victory has started in a new way. So let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe in me also. So simply put, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in Jesus. Just believe in Jesus. Modern translations will not put believe in God. They say, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in Jesus. Period. I mean, period. Verse 11. Believe me, you know, what he started to say, he continued to discuss with them, and a lot of things unfolded. In verse 11, believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the sake of the works themselves. Glory be to God in the highest. And before then, in 10, he has said something in 10. Let me back up to 10. Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? Hallelujah. The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own authority. Hallelujah. But the Father who dwells in me does the works. And we got it right that day, that just say his word, he does the works. But the problem is, how easy is it for you to say his words in your situation? So in 11, it says, believe me that I'm in the Father, and the Father in me, always believe me for the sake of the works themselves. Which works? The work that he does when I speak, not on my own authority. Hallelujah. 12. Most assuredly, now this is serious. Most assuredly, I say to you, Jesus speaking here, I beg you, please pay my attention. Jesus said it before he left, most assuredly, very, very, truly, truly, I say to you, if you are a believer, if indeed you are a believer, the works I do, you will do. Jesus said it. And you know how he started? Believe me, that's what he says. And greater works than this, you will do. Jesus said it. Say, because I go to my Father. And whatever you ask, this is important too, whatever you ask, are you a believer? Whatever you ask, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it, that the Father may be glorified. So that was what I was meditating upon. And I woke up with the rain. And I said, I said, rain again. I said, do you want it like last Sunday? I said, no, sir. He said, then do something. Oh, whatever, if you believe, whatever you say. So I said it. Look at verse 20 of that verse, of that chapter. Ooh. At that day, you know, he was talking of our days. He was yet to die and resurrect and send the Holy Ghost. You will know that I am in my Father and you in me and I in you. It's the Father in me that does the work, because what you see of me is me and the Father. I am flesh and blood, but the Father is in me. That's what differentiates me from all of you. The Father is in me and I am in him. But in that day, you will be in me and I will be in the Father, and the Father will still be in me. So in that day, just like the Father is in me and I'm in him, he will be in you and you will be in him too. That's the definition of Christianity. That's the definition of Christianity. That is what it means to be a son in the kingdom. Whilst he was walking before the cross, he was the only begotten son. After the cross, when men began to believe, sons were made on earth. Sons were produced on earth. Is somebody hearing me? I'm deliberately saying this because it's time our attitude, our understanding changes, and our attitude therefore will change. Every time he talked about that in the Bible, he's talking of human beings. And that what it is what Jesus settled once and for all in all this is teachings. And if that be the case, that means that this human being, this human being, until an encounter with Jesus, was just like the rest. Please permit me to be Jesus today. We are all the Jesus that the world is seeing today. Believe me, I'm not shy about that. I'm not bashful at all. We are his body on earth. We are the living organism that manifests God through his son Jesus on earth today. Not dogs. Not goats. We are his church on earth. Physical. We are members of his body, physical. So that means that all that Jesus, see, all he's saying, all he has been saying since we have been reading is all that he did on earth and all that he will continue to do, rather, will be now committed and limited to us. We will do exactly what he has done, and by virtue of the fact that he's not just in one body anymore, there will be greater works everywhere. And some say, no, the greater works is salvation. Very well. Then you are his witnesses. So there'll be salvation everywhere. Anyhow you look at it. But we are the ones. And until Jesus is revealed from us, nothing will happen. So it's beyond saving us from here or saving us to go to heaven. It is revealing God here on earth. Period. And so when an encounter, when she had an encounter with Jesus, her spirit man, hello, came into union with God's spirit. Not like this. It's such that you won't be no difference anymore. Became one. Her spirit man and God became one. Her spirit man is definite. God's spirit is definite. But they became one in the assignment of her life on earth. So she can say, the Father in me. Like Jesus said, the Father in me. She can say, the Jesus in me. Like he said, you are in me. I'm in the Father. The Father is in me. One. That's the condition for asking what will in my name. It shall be done. So, the interesting is that it is so. But if we don't know it, we cannot actualize it. Because everything here is by faith. And faith is based on knowledge. And so now, God is complete there. Jesus is there. Do you know that she can imprison this Jesus in her spirit the rest of her life if she wants? Refusing to manifest. Allowing the soul and the flesh to dominate. But Jesus is there nevertheless. But the more she gets into the Word of God and being taught by the Spirit in the Word, she begins to realize, oh, I feel the fire now. Then at that point, it's easy to let the flesh understand, because the flesh makes its own demand. But your soul says, no, this is who I am and this is where I'm going. And so your flesh has no choice than to bend and follow, whether it's in the things of sin or lust or sickness or fear or defeat. That's how victory comes. It starts from your spirit, takes over your soul and your body, and isn't it the same way? Why will I a physical being in the name of Jesus? I say, whatever is sick in your body, healing in the name of Jesus. Why? What do you expect? From my hand? It's flowing from my spirit, through my soul, through my hand. Which was exactly what Jesus did. Is somebody understanding what I'm saying? What if I want her? What if I'm planning evil against her? I'm planning evil against her. Every work of the Spirit is complete in her. The appropriate one takes over. Designing of spirit. Word of knowledge. You are the most dangerous species of beings walking the face of the earth. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? Yes, now you can now understand when Jesus looks at her. He says, I am the vine. You are a branch on me. We are one. Because henceforth, all my fruits, all my manifestations on earth will be seen on you. I am still the one, but you will be the one revealing it
to the world. Whether you're talking character or gifts. So like it is written about Jesus, he went about doing good, healing all who were oppressed. It's your turn.
Amen.
Oh, you think it's for fun that he said, you are the light of the world. After he had established that as long as I'm in the world, I remain the light. But you see, I'm ascending. You are the light. He said, the same spirit that is Jesus from the dead. Where does he dwell? And what does he do? He quickens. That's my physical flesh. So whether you eat meat in the night, it will have no effect. In the name of Shoba Shandala Baoloma. What if it realizes that, see, it's not separate Jesus and separate you inside. It walks through you. Like the branch is to the vine. The same life flows through. Otherwise, you'll be changing like weather. No, you are the stability of your generation. In the name of Jesus. It's in line with that that you hear Paul say in Galatians 2:20, I am crucified with Christ. By saying that, his entire being, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but what? Come on, talk to me. Can you see the definition of Christianity? Yet not I, but who? Christ. That what? Lives in me. And the life you see of me now, I live by the faith of the Son of God. He lives his life through me. I'm not a robot. But see, there is a margin. He's fully into me. Somebody says the greatest mystery of Christianity is that God comes to dwell in you. And he has a right of way and a right of action through your faculties. That's why for me and for you, the Christian, Jesus is my wisdom. Why? The words I speak are not mine. And he does the works when his words are spoken. So you think I'll speak fully? He's my wisdom. Because he's my redemption. He's my sanctification. That's why I cannot brag on righteousness. He is my righteousness. That's what qualifies me before God. He is my everything. That's why Paul says I'm complete in him. That's Christianity. But remember where we started from? Aside John 7, which is just trying to buttress the fact that it's high time we allow him to be revealed. Where we started from is that if you believe, the works I do, you will do. And greater works than this, you will do. And if you ask anything in my name, because you are a believer, I will do it. So that the Father may be glorified in the Son. At least not difficult to ask. So that means that you are the threshold of unusual breakthroughs. You are the threshold of unusual miracles. You are the treasure of the supernatural. It's vast before you. In the name of Jesus. Is somebody hearing me? Any child of God in the house? So the life I live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave his life for me. So it's it may not occur. Olorun oba man ni. Abe moruko eni. Oro gbinu omo eni ofo. He cannot be in you and don't speak. He's ever speaking in you. He creates everything he creates by speaking. He orders everything, he orders by speaking. He's in charge of everything, he's in charge of by speaking. He's forever speaking in you. Will you please listen and let him speak and see things fall into line before you in the name of Jesus? I'm talking of what you were expected to do. My part, when I lay my hand in the name of Jesus, healing will take place. When I agree with you in the name of Jesus, there'll be a breakthrough. Why? Because out of my belly shall flow river. Living water. Now understand what Paul meant when he said, my little children over with my labor. Or to Christ be what? Fully formed. Asha. Christ fully formed in you. When you appear. You know, Let me do my wife. He was with Joseph. He wasn't in Joseph. He was with Joseph. Joseph just needed to appear. You will know that God entered. How much more of you is inside? Me. He's with me. He's on me. He's in me. What wisdom is the world trying to bring to thwart you? What tricks? For your assignment, you can never fall short. In the name of Jesus. Pastor, what about the scientific? He will order your steps. Now we understand the prayers of Paul in Ephesians chapter 3. Give me the amplified version. For this reason, seeing the greatness of this plan, what plan? So he dies, like, we won't go to hell. Yes, it is, but that's not the main reason. It's definitely part of it. It defines why he came. That you know, that you just go to heaven. Oh, yes, fine. If those are the only two reasons, then none of us should be alive today. He wants to reveal himself through you during your lifetime. He said the chief end of man is that God will reveal himself continuously throughout your life, and at the end you will live with him in eternity. So let's change that definition and let's see God begins to move. For this is seeing the greatness of his plan by which you are built together in Christ. You know, everybody, well, we are his body, his physical body. Given that I may be part of the finger, or maybe part of his cell, okay? But I'm part of his body. So he will manifest through me. And I have to contribute my quota to the mature body. I bow my knees before the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, yes. For whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. That Father from whom all fatherhood takes his title and derives his name. May he grant you out of the rich treasury of his glory to be strengthened and reinforced with mighty power. Where? In your inner man. By the Holy Spirit. That's why when you see Jesus talking this way, you see him say, and I will pray the Father and he will send you another come. He always talk of the Holy Spirit. Because he won't jump down in a human form to enter you. He's in the spirit form. God in the spirit form. Like God was in the spirit form. Oh, I feel the fire. God was in the spirit form in him. With mighty power in the inner man by the Holy Spirit, himself indwelling your inner. Paul is praying that you will know. And that rather that you will get to this stage and you will realize this thing that he will grant you to be strengthened with might. Mighty power in your inner man by the Holy Spirit himself dwelling in your innermost being and personality. That's where I'm going. Your personality will be affected. It's got nothing to do with whether, what do you call it now? I'm introvert or extrovert. No. We'll still see Jesus. We'll still see joy. We'll still see forgiveness. We'll still see miracles. We'll still see healings. In the name of Jesus. We'll still see breakthroughs. We see demons being cast out. Yes. It doesn't matter which. It doesn't matter whether you are this or that. It doesn't matter whether you are tall or short. What's important is that your spirit man has harbored him. He's found a home there. He has a right of way now to act through you.
May Christ through your faith actually dwell, settle down, abide, make his permanent home in your heart.
And what will be the effect? You'll be what? Come on, help me. In love and grounded in love. It says rooted as in a tree that is planted, grounded as in a house with a solid foundation. In love and founded securely on love. So when Christ spiritually, literally, dwells in your heart, you'll be grounded in love. Now you understand why Jesus was always moved with compassion. That love just flows. That love just explodes as mercy. And when compassion moves you, miracles. He said, I'm praying that you will be strengthened, that Christ will dwell in your heart by faith, that you may be grounded and rooted in love. And you know what? What your wildest dreams you never thought could happen? In the name of Jesus. Why? You are sitting with believers who are beginning to realize who they are. He's praying love from them. That you may have the power and be strong to apprehend and grasp all things. God visited people, yes. And length and wet and drip, yes, quick. That you may really come to know practically through experiencing it for yourself. For yourself. The love of Christ, which far surpasses that knowledge without experience, I think that day is over. Our Christianity is one, we experience Christ. So those who meet us experience him. Unto all the fullness of God now. Say that you might be filled with all the fullness. That's what I'm saying. He will fill your spirit, fill your soul, fill your body. It will ooze out. Amen. See what he told them? Any house you get to, that was before, that was test running. Any house you get to, stand at the door, say, peace. And he gave the impression clearly that peace will leave you embodily and land in the house. You see, if there is no child of peace there, your peace will return. Jesus said it. When he was test running, how much more now that he has done it and he has sent us? I carry something, that's what I'm saying, that affects my body, my home, my ministry, my generation, in the name of Jesus. That's what I'm saying. And that's Christianity. There's no room for self-pity. Let him talk, release him. Fullness of God, that it may have the richest measure of the divine presence. That's it. When God fills you, now you can see that Joseph, favor will just appear. Order will appear. When you appear, no matter how chaotic, if your assignment will take you past that place, something will change. In the name of Jesus. Whatever the devil thought he has concluded about your life, I stand as an oracle of God in the name of Jesus. I reverse it. I say in the name of Jesus, I reverse it. I say I reverse in Jesus' name. Where he had marked the day you are going to die, I cancel it by the blood of Jesus. And in the name of Jesus, I decree you will fulfill your times in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I hope you know I'm not saying go back to sender. I just said I refuse and I turn it back. That is, I reverse. How can he speak and he thinks he will walk? Whatever you have swallowed that you think will kill you, I say it will make you grow life. In the name of Jesus. Every confusion along your path, I cancel in the name of Jesus. The Bible says the path of the righteous has a shining light. So I decree, let it shine brighter, brighter, brighter.